Donal, you're again popping your knuckles. How many times should I tell you not to do that?
I will. What is the problem?
This causes arthritis and you're not listening to me, okay? Do that and you will realize yourself when you will face the repercussions.
Arthritis? Really? How do you know that?
I'm fed up of you and your stupid questions.
This is Donald, soon to be Dr. Donald Unger. Determined to disprove his mother's warnings, this brave boy repeatedly popped knuckles of his left hand for 50 years, while the right hand knuckles went unpopped. His discovery made him win the prestigious Ig Nobel Prize. Watch this video until the end to know what he discovered and what happens when you pop knuckles. Popping knuckles is a pastime of many of us. Some find it relieving, while some cringe at the sound of it. But have you ever wondered, why do knuckles pop? To understand it, first, you need to know a bit about the joints in our body. The types of joints that make pop sound are diarthrodial joints. They consist of two bones that contact each other at their cartilage surfaces. A joint capsule surrounds the cartilage surfaces. Inside the joint capsule is a lubricant known as synovial fluid. Its primary purpose is to cushion the bones and help them move smoothly. The synovial fluid also serves as a source of nutrients for the cells that maintain the joint cartilage. Besides, the synovial fluid contains a lot of dissolved gas molecules, including oxygen, nitrogen, and carbon dioxide. To pop a knuckle, you have to stretch the joint farther than it usually goes. When you do that, the bones move away from each other, and hence, space gets bigger. But the amount of synovial fluid stays constant. That decreases the pressure in the fluid and creates bubbles of dissolved gases, just like the bubbles popping out from a soda drink. The bubbles combine with a pop. When the bones go back to their normal position, then the bubbles slowly get dissolved in the fluid. It takes around 20 minutes for gases to get dissolved. That is why you can't pop knuckles simultaneously. But how can such a small amount of gas cause so much sound? Scientists have estimated the energy levels of the sound by using accelerometers to measure the vibration caused during joint popping. The amount of energy involved is tiny, on the order of 0.1 millijoules per cubic millimeter. Some scientists believe that actually there are two sounds, one when the bubble forms and another when it bursts. The easiest joints to pop are the ones in your fingers. But some people can produce this sound from their neck, shoulder, back, knee, and where not. The noise you often hear from your ankle or knee is due to tendons and ligaments near the joints. When a joint moves, the tendon's position with respect to the joints get changed, and sometimes it changes to a slightly different position than usual, followed by a sudden snap as the tendon returns to its original location with respect to the joint. These noises are often heard while standing up or walking up or down the stairs. Now, a relevant question arises. Does popping a joint cause any damage? Remember the story of Dr. Unger? After 60 years and 36,000 cracks, he found that both hands were perfectly fine. That is, arthritis free. But some studies show that consistent knuckle cracking can cause an increase in hand swelling and a decrease in hand's grip strength. But overall, it is harmless. That's all in this episode of Explained. Till then, enjoy irritating your sibling, parents, and friends.